move on to combination number two. But before we do, okay, let me tell you about a few of the things that I liked that I saw. Number one, I did not hear any negativity when speaking to group members. I did not hear you doing that wrong. I hate that word. Right? I heard people encouraging each other and helping them out.
Oh man! Oh no! We got it! Quick enough, one, Mike, go!
I'm ready!
you know what's in the secret file?
What? It's a what?
It's a secret. Yes. The secrets of all martial arts. So maybe someday she'll come in every once in a while. That's when she comes right in, right? She shares her secrets with us. Team ready, everybody pop it up, please! Let's bring our hands together. Bow out towards structures. Oh. Share a bow to our parents. High five!
Remember team, PCP. Coach Jenny, can you tell us what PCP stands for?
Praise, correct, praise.
Woo! Praise, correct, praise. I even put her on the spot and she got it. Praise, correct, praise. Whenever we need to tell someone or correct them on something, we make sure they praise them first. Can you get in a stance for me? I'm going to pick on you today. She's in a stance where her hands are down. Go ahead and keep your hands down. I'm going to first say to her, wow, you know what, Cindy, you have great footwork. Your stance looks awesome. Don't forget, though, we got to have our hands up. Let me see you do that. Nice job. Oh, our room's going to look great now. And we get right back to it. Okay? I praised her. I corrected what needed to be corrected. And I praised her again. And all of us walk away feeling great. Does everybody understand that? Yes, sir?
Yes, sir.
All right. We're learning how to be leaders. And we're learning how to have great teamwork skills this week. When you do stalking, you have to understand that it's very difficult to move side to side when you're stalking. Stalking is when we break off to each other and we're starting to get back together. When we're in the middle of exchanges, we should be using fast footwork. Is everybody understanding this? And I'll get into a few more details, okay? So if I break off from Sensei Scott or I move an exchange, then I'm stalked when I get back in. The minute we start getting into the area where now I think the exchange is going to happen, now I'm back to in and out footwork. Look at this. Front foot, back foot. I'm here. I can disguise range when I do that. Okay, so I can be back here with Sensei Scott and moving this. And then, bam, like this. I'm already, I'm already right in there for my shots. Okay, because that's being disguised in my movement. Because my movement is getting faster. When my movement gets faster, it's harder for him to time my movement. Does that make sense? Okay, watch what else. I want to move it like this. Sensei Scott comes at me. Like this. Very easy for me to move my body when I'm on my toes and leaning forward. You need to engage on your toes when you're doing your light footwork, and your body weight needs to be forward, because remember, back weight, front weight, back weight, front weight, back weight, front weight, but my head's forward. Okay, so now, the reason why I say this, now when I have to lean to do my head movement, I'm leaning on a back foot, which is a foot that I can push off of.
Stay right at that pace if you have 1 minute.
Now, every wolf that's in a pack has a specific job. There's the alpha male and alpha female, which are the leaders of the pack. There's the beta male and beta female, which are second in command. There's the omega that's at the bottom of the pack. And then hunters and caretakers. With the team, what I want you to understand is I want you to think about things that you do in life. Think about when you are by yourself and you're building Legos and how much fun it is. But think about how much more you accomplish when you have a friend over and you create a mission with one another. Now you have two people building, okay? Is it difficult to be a part of a team? Is it difficult when your friends are over and they're playing with your toys and they're putting their ideas in there? Absolutely. But at the end of the day, you get so much more done, of course. Think about when you go places and you have the support of a friend, especially when you enter an uncomfortable situation. One of the best examples that was ever taught to me by one of my instructors, when my instructor brought in a pile of sticks, okay, and he handed me one stick in front of the classroom, and he said, "Carl, I want you to break this stick," and I snapped it, no problem. Then he took all the other sticks, and he put them together and wrapped an elastic band around them, and he handed me the sticks in front of the class, and it embarrassed me. He said, "Now break this stick," and I grab all the sticks together, and I'm now the kids are giggling in the room, right? I take one more swipe at it. Nothing. Not even one of those sticks in that group cracked. Why? Strength in unity. Okay? It is very important to remember strength in unity as a martial artist. That's why, whether it's a family member, a friend at school, someone from BTB, and you see something happen at school, you should always stick together and always do what is right, team. That is what it takes to be a part of a team or part of a pack.
Oh, hit for me, hit!
Little giraffe fells. Coming back up. Alright. Sitting on the floor. We're just pointing forward. Leaving your chest go.
Jenny is teacher by day, martial artist in the evening, but at night she's superhero.
She's super
Jenny. Super Jenny. Coach Jenny has many different names, doesn't she? Secret agent Jenny, superhero. Everybody had a great job today. Does anybody have any questions about today? No questions.
Sir.
Alright, take your hands. That instructor's turn to our parents.
Puss, excellent job. Nice work today. Nice job. Make sure we're always saying nice positive things to our teammates at the end of the show.
Great work today.